luxuries tend to become necessities and to spawn new obligations. Hey, I'm Nivya, and today I'm going to review two amazing books by Yuval Noah Harari. The first one, Sapiens, A Brief History of Humankind, and the second one, Homo Deus, A Brief History of Tomorrow. Well, the first book, Sapiens, deals with the evolution or the journey of Homo sapiens throughout the centuries to what we are currently, while Homo Deus deals with the abilities that we acquire through the existence, what we have currently, the abilities that we have currently, and the possibilities of tomorrow, future. Alright, so let's first start with Sapiens. To dig in further into the book Sapiens, A Brief History of Humankind, human history has been shaped majorly by three revolutions: cognitive, agricultural, and scientific. Cognitive revolution occurred between 70,000 to 30,000 years ago. This is when sapiens evolved imagination. Basically, that's when Homo sapiens started to communicate at a level never seen before or until then. People could collaborate, pass on their ideas or myths via language. The agricultural revolution occurred around 10,000 years ago, the period when we did not domesticate wheat. Rather, wheat domesticated us, because Homo sapiens began to invest more effort in cultivating wheat. The agricultural revolution did not, in fact, make life of average human better at first. However, it allowed humans to collect more food per unit area, and thus overall population multiplied exponentially. The agricultural revolution was accompanied by a religious revolution. The scientific revolution started in Europe 500 years ago, while humans first evolved in Africa about 2.5 million years ago. The transition, even geographically, is clearly depicted in this book. The author has clearly mentioned how liberalism, capitalism, humankind, money, religion, nationalism, communism, all of these, how they emerged and evolved. Though the subject history of humankind is quite difficult to feed into our brains because it's so vast, right? I mean, there's so much of information. The author has been able to simplify it in such a way that anyone and everyone can easily understand it. Also, you'll get to see a lot about Indian content, as in how these subjects, whatever I mentioned, how they all emerged in India. Though it's across the globe, it is mentioned, you'll see a large part of it about India as well. Alright, with that, let's go to the second book now, Homo Deus, A Brief History of Tomorrow. Homo Deus, A Brief History of Tomorrow was published in 2016, while Homo Sapiens was published in 2011. This book mainly deals about the current period to future. In order to give you a concrete idea on what this book is about, I'll read a few sentences written behind this book, okay? You are more likely to commit suicide than be killed in conflict. You are more at risk of obesity than starvation. Equality is out, but immortality is in. What does our future hold? Since this book deals a lot about future, they are all possibilities and not that they will certainly happen. Like, for example, this book mentions that the chance of an outbreak of epidemic is less, or we can easily come out of it, or we can fight against it easily because of the advancement of science, technology and medicine. But we know how the pandemic, COVID-19, conquered the world. So this book is mainly possibilities or likelihoods. So we cannot say that they will certainly happen. This book clearly depicts that we do not become satisfied by leading a peaceful or prosperous existence. Rather, we become satisfied when reality matches our expectations. Bad news is that our conditions improve, expectations balloon. I personally liked Sapiens' book more than Homo Deus because I felt Homo Deus was somewhere going towards a direction of self-help, which was quite repetitive, while Sapiens was far more informative. And if you're planning to read these two books, then definitely go for Sapiens first in the order itself and only then pick Homo Deus. So that's about these two books, and until we meet next time, keep reading a lot of books, and if you've not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe. This is Nivya signing off. Take care. Happy reading.